Hey guys, just another gamer here, and for today, I'm not going to do on Trial Ascension, of course, because I can see that they're all cleared. So what I'm actually going to talk about is that I'm going to talk about the units that I use, because I had a subscriber actually asked me like to show him on like my rune. So I think since I actually made some vast changes, which I have not totally tried on any of these units at all, not even like autoing of the Trial Ascension anyway anyhow, so I think I shouldn't be on like the floor 100. I should be like on like example floor 95, because right now what I'm going to say is that the units that I use for like the any of the 1 to 9 stages, except on the boss stages, so unless specifically they are like different mobs wise, such as like the Occult Girl stage or like the Artamiel stage, then probably I'll like just switch them around for like the main stuff. So for now, this will be like the general of my team. This will be not be the one on auto, because the auto one, I don't think it will actually fancy anybody, I guess. Probably not, I guess, but I might show that later for like for those. So to begin with, I have will be Beretta, which definitely will be the lead, because I do not get the logic whereby why do you want to like tank on like Trial of Ascension, especially on hard mode? You just want to kill them, CC them, everything. You do not want to like tank them for like 2 turns, 3 turns, 4 turns, whatever, because you just want to like CC them, not take any single bit of damage, and just proceed on with the stage. So for the first one we have is Beretta, which is on a despair focus. So the skills are all max, and then it comes with a leader skill of like 19% speed. So I'll just like go through on the stats. Some of them are purple, I know, because these are like PvE, which in my opinion I don't really care about this. So in my opinion, for this you don't really need a focus set. You can just use despair, that's one, or else you go for violent, doesn't really matter. If like Ashubel, which is the dark sylph, that one wise, then of course you go for like violent, because his third skill doesn't really care about despair. So that's well about it for this guy. So speed, HP, accuracy, if you actually remember correctly. Then next up we have is Vermos. So this is all sets of Vermos. I think I don't need to like touch on the runes for this. Obviously it'll be on speed and HP and HP. So Swift is because that my violent runes are like prioritized on like my other units, so I do not have like actually additional kind of like spare set for Vermos, because even if I have, I do not have the speed which I want, which could be around this amount of speed, like 210-ish. So he's currently on Swift and Nemesis. Previously I was like having a guard set, so I'll show you guys the guard set where I place it on. Next up we have, which will be Train. So Train is, I'm using just a violent broken set, reason being is for the speed. So how I actually plan this, okay, maybe I talk about the planning in like after this. So as you will also notice, there'll be like speed, then HP and speed subs, of course, because Train has like insanely low kind of like Train has insanely low kind of like the speed. I'll show you guys. Yep, so this is like the rough rune set, and then his speed is 91, so you need like additional crazy amount of like of all this speed to actually patch up, because I want like a fast team, of course, and I want to like go 2 times or even 3 times faster than the opponents. So that's like something I'm going to try in June 15 on a June 15 not in John in on June 15. Okay, pardon me on that. Then Aria wise is okay, despair is also there, but the energy is like there not to be there. Why, I'll tell you why later. Then cause it has like this one has like speed subs. I think I just changed the speed sub like recently. And then it has like accuracy, so something which I need. And then to compare with this, I have like 23% subs for HP from this rune, so I think that why not I just use like an energy rune. Yep. Last but not least we have is Theon. So this is where the guard set it gone to. So Theon is like okay, I'll talk about the strategy wise later. So these are the rough set of it. So this is the guard set that I was saying, it has like 13 speed here, and the other piece has 21 speed. So I use this, like I mean I certainly love this set, and I couldn't bear to actually remove it from Vermos, but I want Nemesis on Vermos, so practically that's much it. So how I actually plan this lineup is that the okay, maybe just enter the match or the battle, then we'll just talk about like how I actually plan on like this whole unit or like this setup. It's rather quite simple, I guess I would say. So what it is that I do not care who goes first, but Aria or Vermos, it doesn't matter. That's in my opinion. Of course, you want them to be as fast as possible, so right after next, you'll just do on this skill. So here's where actually the strategy of my lineup comes in. I'll use on the Phoenix Fury. Whoever is stuns or put on a dot, as long as you put on the dot, I'm okay. So even let's say the third unit at the center doesn't have any of the dots. So what I'm going to do is that I'm going to use Plaque to put on dots or even more dots. Then let's assume that I didn't get the Venom proc. I'll just do a normal hit. So this is where the next strategy would come in. Kion would do the research on train, and then I'll do the Doomsday. Yep, so usually on the average I get like 3 to 4 guys stun up right at the start of the stage. So that's like how actually I plan my units for this. So I guess now we'll proceed on to like the boss stages. Alright, so for the boss stages, usually this is the lineup that I use. So I know I do have a head tall here, so it will be like a different case scenario as compared. So I think I will not touch on this lineup. So I will now change to another lineup, which is, I would say, is pretty average. And then I'm able to actually use this to actually solo most of the bosses the other time. But I mean, they aren't on auto mode, but if you can refer up to the cards, I actually included something there, which is the team or the other video which you guys can actually view on. If you guys actually block on the ads, just go to the description bar below. I will actually like insert that link there. So whatever you do, you will still be able to see unless you don't click on any of them. Okay, so I'll change to that team. Okay, so before I went into the Hathor mode like a few months ago, this is the other team which I mean I just mentioned it earlier. So this is like a common team which I say you can actually use this to actually complete this. And at the same time, the link there has like the runes of like so many months ago, so that could be like a bit different bit from what I'm going to show here. So anyways, I'm still going to show. So first off, we have his Beretta. So wait, I already gone through Beretta. Then Vermos also I just went through. Next up, actually, I would say these are the core team which I need, which will be Bernard and Spectra. So Bernard, these are the rough sets of it. Mine is on like a speed, HP, accuracy. I do not use this in anywhere like outside of PvE content. I do not use Bernard at all. So that's why my Swift is practically shit. I would say that. I know you guys could have like I have like a 300 speed Bernard. Yeah, I'm okay with it because my guys are like, you can see that I major more into like the real runes. So okay, so next up we have is Spectra. Yep, so Spectra wise, what I need is that she actually, I do not know if it's she or is it he, but what Spectra needs is a critical rate, because with this skill, if you actually use Bernard to put on a defense break, then this unit can actually deal a fair bit of damage, which is a very very high damage. So this is actually my main damage dealer in like most of my trial ascension videos, if you actually notice. And I'd like to reiterate on this again, you need the defense break at this instance in order for this special assault to deal a good damage. Same like what you guys saw yesterday on like my Sigmaris, which Sigmaris did I think like 34.5k on the dragons. Yep, I have the attack buff and also have the defense break on the dragon. So that's how actually you dish out a super big damage on the opponent. So okay, I know I sound kind of like fierce right here, but yeah. Because the other time a guy was asking me like stuff which is like something a little bit different which I can't remember, so he couldn't actually dish out the same damage even having like better stats than mine. Yep. So last but not least, actually I would say that you need a very good provoker. So another alternative from this which you can actually use will be like a Talc. I'll show you guys Talc later. So my Berserk is for PvP purposes, and I use this in like my PvE also in like Trial of Ascension, because this Hellstorm is actually a very good skill. And then I have like superb runes for my this Berserk. I actually love Berserk very much. So you guys might ask me like why I use Blade. I'll show you guys why I use Blade. You can see there's 20% accuracy here. I have like 20% HP, and then I changed the subs to speed, which I think I got like minimal roll the other time for like this rune. And the next rune for blade, I also got the minimal runes, minimal rolls for the speed. So kind of like, I mean, anyways, you get like tons of all these kind of like blade, the enchanted stones. So I think I don't really care, but I have like more speed right now. This addition of the 8 plus 7, that's 15 speed, so it won't really go wrong. Then for the rest of the runes, so I got like 17 speed here. So definitely the main core issue about this is 17 speed. Next up is this one, I think, is for like the defense, resistance and accuracy, because from the start my basalt don't really have like crazy amount of like those how should I put it? Oh yeah, speed subs, especially on like rune 3 and rune 5. Yep, okay, rune 5 actually have like quite an okay speed here. I didn't even notice about that. So then rune 4 is also speed. So yeah, practically just for these two runes, which actually makes my basalt quite rather tanky. And at the same time, the heal is like very minimal, because if you see this total amount of HP, which is like around 20k, if you multiply it by like around 18%, because the base heal is for this is 15%, but then if you add in the additional skill ups, which is like a 10%, that is 10% of the 15%, so two of it will be 3%, total will be 18%. So the heal is quite minimal. So I would say that basalt is actually more like needed in like stages like this Sierra stage, because Telt can't do the job, in my opinion. Unless you use Armand, then Armand should actually do the same kind of job. So next up for this, for the boss stages, if say we do not have like a basalt, I have Telt here, which could also do almost the same kind of job. So let me just put Telt there. Okay, so Telt for my case is on Violent and Endure, because I think Endure was like okay to receive some bomb sometime. So I just put Endure there, or maybe something like tanking, or like the Wind Monkey example on the Artamiel stage. So for Artamiel stage, I'll like do something like that somehow. Okay, so I'll go on the Artamiel stage like right after this. So these are the rune stages, I mean the rune set for like my this Telt. Isn't really that really good, because you can see the speed is only like 48. I think I should like change this rune to like a more speedy one. Maybe I could have like 15% speed or some, I mean 15 more speed maybe. Probably are something that I can look into like the next one. Alright, so for this kind of stage, such as the one like this, the Occult Girls, what I feel that I would actually consider is, most people will say I'm using Vermos, but Vermos can't stun the two of these Occult Girls. So what I actually use is actually Chloe to do on the invincibility and also on the immunity. So I feel that this line up helps me way much more. And then on the other hand, if you guys, I mean, still the same case, if without basalt, go for Telt, because you can actually tank on the Win OG, which is Charlotte, because Charlotte is wind, and then I only have like a unit which is only water in that case if I'm using Telt. So no matter how, Telt will be the one taking damage, and if anything goes wrong, I still have like attack buff, the attack debuff on the opponent, which is the OGs, and I only max like my Brienne from like the Diaz and the Conrad Hall of Heroes. Then if anything else goes wrong, I can actually revive using supply from Brienne. Then yep, of course, Arya will be there to like do it on the CC, because this kind of stages is like pretty hard. So I think the next one I'll move on to, which will be Artamiel. Okay, in regards to Artamiel stage, this is floor 17 normal this month, which doesn't really quite matter, because I'm just going to talk through about the strategy. So in my opinion, for this kind of stage, I think that immunity should and could help us like way more, and at the same time, Chloe has a heal, so it should be much better. So the only changes which I changed from the OG stage to Artamiel stage is that I'm using Telt. Reason being is that Telt is the one that can actually help in like tanking on like the two Wind Monkeys, which you do not want them to actually hurt any of your other guys. So especially is like Arya, so that's why because Arya is rather squishy. If this Artamiel stage is back and AT hard next month, I think that Brienne is the one that could be actually be like the savior because of this attack break and the heal. I mean the revive. And I need this Brienne and also Arya there because Brienne first skill will be able to do on like the heal block. Then Arya's second skill will be able to also do on the heal block. So I just want to, you just need the heal block there to actually waste on the heal from Artamiel, which is this skill, Archangel's Blessing. So practically that's much. And then if haven't got Arya, I think that someone told me to use like Shannon, the Wing Pixie the other time. So he has a mass slow and then a single target of the glancing. So maybe that can help, but I'm not too sure because I already have like Arya and I personally went to fuse like at least 8 or 10 of them to actually skill her up. The rest of them will be like for summons. Yep, and then I think the next one which will be Vermos, so I will change the units there. Alright, so against Vermos stage, this is like the rough lineup that I use because I need Ashes for like this small heal. I mean, that's a little bit optional, but I want the speed buff. That's the thing that I want. Then Berserk will be as usual because if you can actually do on like attack break and then you do some defense buff, you are actually very good to go. Of course, Vermos will actually remove on like those debuffs. So that is why that I don't use Arya for this stage. Not even using Hua, as a matter of fact. Then Brienne will be there to actually help on like the heal block, just to actually put on additional debuffs so that I can actually clear on like the mobs like a little bit faster. So I still prefer Chloe in this stage as compared to using Vermos. I know Vermos can actually do the stun and also apply the dots, but in like higher stages I prefer to go very 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 safe to and in order to actually clear on like all these mobs, especially on like the two Hordems. So for the Perna wise, I use Brienne to actually tank on my on the Pernas. And for those of you guys who have Vert, okay, I think you guys should be good to go. I guess that you guys could be like, I mean, swap Asher for like Vert, I guess. That's what I think should be a good way to go. Then, I think that's all for what I have. So let me see what else do I can actually like touch on for the Trial of Ascension. Okay, so I think the last part that I would like to touch on, which will be on like the notable units. So the first of all, for the notable units I have, which will be math. So this math is like practically like crap for mine because I do not use math at all, because I'm too used to like the first team that I show you guys in like the most of the level 1 to 9 stages, every level 1 to 9 stages. Then the other notable units which I have, I actually did plan them, but I have not used them at all. So the next one will be Michelle, and the last one which will be Neil. So I think that they are still buffing up some of like the Ragdoll or like the Jotun or the Kume stage, the Dark Yeti. So I think that in time to come, I might actually need to prepare these two units to actually do on like something else. Yep, because or else I don't think like it's getting tougher to actually clear on like some of those stages, especially like the 4 Ragdolls and the Leo. So I actually made it through some luck and the RNG and the Violent Fox. So I took like at least I think more like 5 refills to actually just to try to beat that floor 93 on hard mode last month. So yep, this team still works for this. I mean, the 5 that you are seeing above, it still works. But I think I need to have like a much better or like a better kind of like plan to actually work out for this stage. I know that sometimes like the Leo or like the Ragdoll will actually aim for like Michelle, but then too bad. Some stuff is just to be there and it can't be helped. And then, oh yeah, another thing that I could actually think of which will be trained, it has the other unit which is called Hermos, which is the Water Green Reaper. So if you don't have trained, and although this weekend we'll still be having the train on like the Guardian rewards, if you actually made it to Guardian, I actually got like the second train, but that's like not the point. So if you are still lacking of train or like you think that train should actually help you out, and but you still cannot get it, it's either on like the 24th, you get the Light in Darkness scroll, then you just summon it, or else will be like from the L&D scroll from like the floor 90. So last of all, which will be just making the Hermos for the time being. So that's like the only few options which I can actually suggest out. Yep, and then any other thing which I can actually add on, which will be like using on like bombers. So bombers could be like another way out to actually trial ascension. I'm actually making this bomber for like no reason, but I'm just putting it there for now. Maybe like in time to come, with maybe I get like another like padded bombers, like maybe like the Dark Joker or like the like Cobalt bomber. Maybe I can actually make this guy out. So until then, I'm still like stuck with this build. And then for now, I think I have actually touched on like most or like all the content for like my trial ascension. Because I've been like completing the hard mode for at least now it's really June, so I think I've like completing trial ascension for like at least 8 or 9 months already, I guess. So I'm like already seasoned player for trial ascension, which nowadays I'm not going to rush for like the thing because it's like very tiring for like very one day. I know I can actually complete it within like a day or like 2 days the maximum, but I think it doesn't quite matter anymore. Because I'm quite contented with like the best results that I have already. So I hope that in my perspective that I'm actually able to help you guys out into the trial session, and then possibly I'm hoping that you guys make like a more fine decision in like making new mods for that like, trial session. In any other case, I think you are still paired off with dungeon runs to get like more runes and like paired units or even mystical scrolls like I do, because I in my journey of like the free to play, what I only do is that I only farm the dungeons and then I just use the mystical scrolls I summon, and then probably maybe could get like some good units. So yep, I guess that's all for what I have to offer and share with you guys from yesterday and today. Then I guess I'll see you guys tomorrow for the Call of Heroes video. Yep, so until then, I hope if any other questions you guys will just feel free to like pop the questions in the comment section, or then I receive some private message sometime, but then I may have actually missed them out. So but comments is like directly a notification to me, so just feel free to leave a like comment below. Then I will see you guys in tomorrow's video for the Hall of Heroes. Yep, so thanks for watching and then goodbye.